Hi, I'm Scotty. I service, repair and restore vintage and antique mechanical clocks. Welcome to Scotties Clock World.
This movement has been brought in for service. It's a German clock movement and runs for 2 or 3 minutes and then it stops. So we have to find out what the problem is. I think it's most likely that the pallets are dropping too deeply into the escape wheel, I think. But we'll try it out and see what we've got. The three springs have been wound up about halfway. So there's plenty of tension on the works. We'll give that a minute and just see when it stops. And then we can start to find out what the problem is. This part here is called the back cock. This is the crutch. This piece coming down here. The suspension spring. This is a pendulum leader. And that's a pendulum bob. To make adjustments on the pallet to drop them deeper into the escape wheel or lift them out, we use these two screws here. We loosen those off, and in behind each of those screws is an elongated slot. So what we do is we loosen the screws off a little bit so there's a little bit of movement, as you saw before. Then we move the back cock up and down, left and right, with our beat amplifier on, and we can tell when the clock is in beat quite easily. And we just keep adjusting the left hand side and the right hand side up and down slowly until we get it in beat exactly. Then we tighten off those two screws, and that's how easy it is. Pendulum seems to be working alright at the moment. We'll advance the wheel to 3/4. Advance it again. Striking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, it doesn't seem to be too bad. I'll make an adjustment on the pallets because I think that is probably what the problem is. I'll make an adjustment on that and we'll check it out again. I'll lower this pallet a tiny little bit. That was pretty loose. Bring it down marginally. Start the pendulum again. And check to see I'll tighten the screw up. Check the other side. Now it's caught. Right, so loosen this up a tiny bit. Yep, going way too deep. Bring it up. Yep, definitely caught on the pallet because it stops there. Rotates forward, but it won't move backwards. What have we got? Yep. Swing a bit violently there. Up a tiny bit. See what we've got. Right, we'll turn that round, have a look at it, and just check it from the front. You can see the escape wheel turning now. The pallets are working correctly. That's what the problem was. The pallets were dropping too deep into the escape wheel. You can see I have a beat amplifier attached to the movement to make it easier to get the clock movement into beat. If you look, you can see that the escape wheel is turning very freely. You can see the pallets are now working properly and the clock is in beat. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about antique and vintage clock repair, be sure to hit the subscribe button before watching these next two videos.